Hey you, have you ever wanted to go on a theme park ride so epic, so spine-chillingly awesome that it would literally kill you? Sorry, what was that? I couldn't hear you over the sound of how awesome this roller coaster is. Also, it will kill you. Hi, my name's Elliot. I'm 4 years into my degree to become an engineer and scientist, and what is this? Who did this? Why? This is the Euthanasia Coaster, created in 2010 by Lithuanian artist
Ilyanas Urbonas.
As his job title might suggest, it's not a real roller coaster, but rather an art project that only exists as a 1 to 500 scale model, and as a concept to make us think about our own mortality. But in practice, how would it work? Well, you have this huge 500 meter climb, followed by a drop to build up speed. Then you go through 7 consecutive loop-de-loops that each get smaller, and you come out on the other side dead. But you might be wondering how we went from this to this. To explain how, we've got to talk about G-force. And I don't mean the 2009 Disney film about guinea pigs. G-force is a measure of acceleration, with 1g being the force of gravity we experience on Earth. You can think of each successive g as an extra u's worth of weight being pushed down on you, so at 2g's you would be twice your weight, 5g's 5 times. This roller coaster is designed to make the riders experience about 10 g's for 1 minute. That's what all the loops are for, and that's what's supposed to kill you. The reason the loops get smaller is to maintain that constant g-force as the coaster itself slows down due to energy loss. So, 10 g's doesn't sound like a very fun experience, but how does that compare to other places you would encounter high g-forces? Well, existing roller coasters can vary a lot in terms of g-force. Some only put you under a couple of g's, while the more extreme can make you experience up to about 5 g's for short periods. Prior to 2006, the highest g-force roller coaster in the world was the Tower of Terror in South Africa, with a maximum of 6.3 Gs, but it since has been refurbished to be a bit more chill, with a new maximum of around 4 Gs. Let's take a look at astronauts who have to endure special training and be in peak physical condition. A space shuttle leaving the atmosphere puts the astronaut under about 3 Gs, which doesn't actually seem too bad. Although, the process of re-entry for the astronauts of the Apollo missions subjected them to forces as high as 7.19 Gs. Similarly, Air Force pilots can be subjected to G-forces all the way up to 9 Gs for a few seconds when turning during flights. So they too require extensive training and have to be in very high physical health. But why do you need all this training to experience such high G-forces, and how would 10 Gs even kill you? Think about when you're in an accelerating car and you feel like you're pushed back in your seat. This is similar to that, but like 20 times stronger, or more. The danger is not that you're going to sustain an injury like a broken limb, but rather, all the blood in your body is also subject to this pushing force, and it will be pushed out of your brain, starving it of oxygen. When this happens, you'll begin to experience tunnel vision, with your field of view beginning to narrow. This will be coupled with the loss of color vision, also known as greying out. If you remain under such a high g-force for long enough, your field of vision will narrow until there's nothing left, and shortly after, you'll completely lose consciousness. I'm sure you can understand the dangers of losing consciousness when in a jet engine, or a spacecraft hurtling towards the Earth, even just for a moment. So it's important that people in these positions have trained their bodies to withstand such high forces. But it also depends a lot on the orientation of your body to the force. For instance, you've probably seen how astronauts sit sideways when launching. This makes the forces much more tolerable for longer periods of time, as they're essentially just being pushed back into their chairs. The Euthanasia roller coaster, on the other hand, due to the loop-de-loops, will ensure that their g-force is always towards the rider's feet, meaning all their blood will be pushed down their body, making it incredibly hard for the heart to supply blood and therefore oxygen to the brain. There's some debate as to whether the roller coaster would actually kill an average person, as it can take a few minutes with a lack of oxygen in the brain before death. But it's almost certain nobody could remain conscious through the whole ride, and at that point it's not like you'd know if you died anyway. So, why did he even design this? I don't know, he's an artist, they do weird things. Thanks for watching this video. If you enjoyed, please consider leaving a like, a comment, and subscribing, and checking out my other work on similarly silly science.